is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit.
Good morning, everyone. Once again, I'm here with a new devotion. And all through this week, we would like to focus on the second coming of Jesus Christ and the signs of the end things. When you read Gospel of Matthew chapter 24 and 25, that's a place where you read about his arrival and the end of the world. When you go through the series of events in the history, you will understand that whenever humanity went through the crisis, people always look back into the Word of God and they begin to relate all those heartbreaking events with the second coming of Jesus Christ, and also they relate with the end of the world. And right now, when you go into the different websites, when you go into the different public platforms, social platforms like YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, you will find that right now, the whole world, especially the Christian world, is focusing more on the second coming of Jesus Christ and also focusing on the end of this world. Non-Christian world, they are referring back to different prophecies done by some of the people in the history. They are looking back and forth. They are trying to understand that is there any prophecies these people have done regarding this current crisis. I'm speaking to the believers this morning. You don't have to get frightened. You don't have to lose your heart. You don't have to feel hopeless because of the lockdown, because of the spread of the coronavirus. Rather, you and I, we must rejoice with the fact that his arrival is at hand. He is coming back. And you and I, we must rejoice that he's coming to take you and me. He doesn't want us to go through the tribulation. He doesn't want us to go through the suffering. And his arrival is at hand, friends. And here I would like to take you through a study that Jesus is coming soon. I remember in the year 1978-79, I was a teenage boy. During that period of time, I remember preachers, they would preach about the second coming of Jesus Christ, and they would preach that the end is going to be there. The world is going to be destroyed totally and completely. And those were the days when church was going through a persecution, because in our country, anti-conversion bill was implemented and church was harassed. Number two, that was a period when American satellite Skylab was falling. So every day, newspapers and magazines, they would print about the events which will take place. And since world did not have much of a technology, so the world did not know where this Skylab, this satellite would fall. So fear was everywhere, because with the fall of that Skylab, people, they would think that some of the countries would be destroyed. So preachers, they begin to preach the end is at hand. Repent. Preachers begin to preach Jesus is coming soon. Get ready. Friends, you and I, we grew up in the Lord with this faith that our Savior is going to reveal himself, and he will come in the clouds. He will come riding the chariots of fire one day, and he will appear one day. every knee will bow down, every tongue will confess that He is the Lord and God. So, to prepare ourselves, I would encourage you this week, you must study Gospel of Matthew chapter 24 and 25. And tomorrow when we go through the study, we will understand what Bible talks about the arrival of Jesus Christ, His second coming, and also about the end of all things, the end of the world. Must read Gospel of Matthew chapter 24 and 25. And when you read Gospel of Matthew chapter 24, I'm going to conclude with these two questions. Here it says very clearly, Jesus is talking to His disciples, and disciples, they're asking Him two questions. In verse 3, He says here, while He was sitting at the Mount Olive, disciples, they came and asked Him two questions. Number one, what would be the sign of your coming and when the world will end? What would be the signs of your arrival, your coming, and when the world is going to end? These are the two questions disciples, they asked. And that's what the question you and we are asking right now. We are asking this question, when are you going to come, O Lord? And when the world is going to end? And with this pandemic, this crisis, this question is coming to our mind almost every day. We're going to search for the answer tomorrow. God bless you, friends. Have a wonderful day. Let me pray with you. Jesus, I commit each and every believer who's watching this devotion. God, give us strength, give us patience, and Father God, put a joy of hope in our heart, O God Master, so that we can prepare ourselves for your arrival. We know, O God, we believe, O God, that you are coming soon. I pray for the suffering world. Father God, be merciful to the people who are in need right now. Reveal your knowledge so that vaccines and treatment can be developed. In Jesus' name, Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.